Second gate. Oh, beautiful. Apart from the monstrosity over there, that's Hunterston. Not a soul. Totally alone here. No one else coming this way. Quite a few going up the tourist path at Brodick from Brodick Castle. I don't see anyone here. Oh, it's just lovely. So that gate is a mile in, a mile up through the trees there, which is very nice. Apart from the midges. The midges are out in force. I'm all itchy. I forgot to put sun cream on, so I stopped down there for a good while and slathered it on. You've got to in this sun. So, off up the hill now. Oh, Goatfell. North Goatfell. I'll maybe do north first and then go along that ridge, up and down those bits, along to Goatfell. I don't know. There's people in front of me now, I can see. Actually, climbing over. Didn't expect that. I thought it would be bright sunshine the whole day. Kind of misty cloud. Well, makes it a bit cooler. Here's a parting of the ways. This way, going straight, it's back up here, up the, through the Corrie, onto North Goatfell, onto the ridge there. But you can go that way across the river. And you can go up to Goatfell that way. If you're coming back to Corrie, that would be the way down. You'd come down here and join the path again. And you'd go up this way. This is a kind of the way to go up. Well, the way it's most favoured. But you could go up Goatfell that way. But if you fancy it being a wee bit easier. But I fancy going up the Corrie. Along the ridge, so that's what I'm going to do. I'll not come down this way because I'll go down to Brodick probably. I could come down this way and get a bus right enough, I've never done that before. Yeah, probably just go to Brodick. I've got time. I think it's maybe 5 or 6 miles into Brodick from Goatfell. From the start here up onto the well, to either North Goatfell or Goatfell proper, it's 2.5 miles. So I've done nearly 1.5 miles, so it's about 1.5 miles in that split. I don't know if this is very interesting for anybody. They're just talking a lot of rubbish or stating the obvious. But that's my want, it's what's in my mind at the time. Apart from Sharon, she's in my mind as well. I lie and gaze into a clear blue sky, chase a floater across my eye, drift to sleep among the gentle hills, a panacea for all my ills. On the beach a lonesome curlew calls, squirrel finds his dray when darkness falls. See the stars in Borealis rays, and worldly cares melt without a trace. Fain, my love, we could with fate conspire to grasp the sorry scheme of things entire. Would not we shatter it to bits and then we mould it nearer to the heart's desire? While this old world goes round the sun, all its weary schemes will ne'er be done. There's a way among the grassy knolls for you and me and all the seeking souls. Let us run to where cool waters flow, purple heather and green rushes grow. Lochs and trees compose anent the hills, and all of nature her joy fulfills. We lie and gaze on heaven's azure eye, trace the swallow across the sky, finding love among the gentle hills, a panacea for all our ills. Finding love among the gentle hills, a panacea for all our ills. Just a wee ditty I made up. I quite like it. Don't know if anyone else will. There's a ferry on the way back over to the mainland. Two girls have passed, stopped down there. I said to me, "You're going really fast." Some kind of European, very dark hair, Spanish, Italian, Portuguese, something like that, I would reckon. Maybe I was a wee bit ignorant, I didn't stop to talk to them, just exchanged the kind of hellos and pleasantries, and then I said, "Have a nice day." I suppose I really should have had a word for a minute or two. Sometimes you're just in the middle. It's a steep bit again, up onto the ridge. Then it's just fun. I think probably the toughest bit is the bit to start with, not through the forest and the wee bit after that. It's a wee bit steep like this. Because you're not used to it yet, first half hour maybe is kind of a bit strenuous. But once you get to this, even though it's kind of steep, it's not too bad. I've been on a lot worse. Ben Vane or Ben Moore, they're an awful lot worse than this. In fact, I'd venture to say this, although it's slightly steeper, is maybe the easier way to go up Goatfell. It seems harder, but it's not such a long walk, and I don't know, I just think it might be a wee bit easier. I haven't been up the other way for a wee while, for years, so I can't remember, but certainly coming down it, you get the impression that it just takes forever. Whereas this is quite quick. Lassies just seem to have stopped. They were knackered. If an old man like me can do it, they can. Just thinking, this is a part of the hill where I met a Swedish woman, young woman. Must be in about mid-20s, late-20s probably, maybe 30. A few years back when I came up this way, and they came from miles away. I could see them getting closer and closer. I thought, no, I'm no sloping up these hills, I'll stay in front of them. But I couldn't. They caught up with me and then they walked along for maybe 5 minutes yapping. Typical Swedes. Big, probably 6 feet, blonde, gorgeous, very fit. All they talked about was ice cream, obsessed with ice cream. Asking me where to get the best ice cream. I was telling about the Forum Cafe in Kilmarnock, or that place in Irvine, I can't remember the name. And eventually, I was just going too slow for them and they shot away. I attained the ridge long before me. But I'd said to them, you were here on holiday, etc., the usual kind of stuff. Oh aye, we're here to do the Edinburgh Marathon. I says, oh, when are you doing it? Tomorrow. After doing this, this was just a wee bit of exercise, a bit of fun before going and doing the Edinburgh Marathon. Looking at ultra runners, just amazing how tough some people are. Nearly up. That's a holy isle peeking up over there. There's Goatfell, the people at the top. Along the ridge this way. Nearly at the ridge. And along there, North Goatfell. So you can go up that first. And then come along here, over these rocky bits. To Goatfell, and then down to Broadick. It's much quieter. Well, these lassies are catching up a wee bit, they're doing no bad. There's another couple of people coming behind. Forgot I was standing on a rock. Right. I might as well go and do North Goatfell, since I'm here. You don't have to go over those rocky bits in the ridge. Scramble. There is a way around about. I'll decide what to do once I'm going that way. Rocky path. Gave out there just to grass for that final wee stretch up on the ridge. Path goes that way to Goatfell. And then to the right to North Goatfell. So I might as well go do that. Just spectacular. Oh, the views from Goatfell are second to none. Really, look at those rocks. What a fantastic walk. Goatfell and headed over to this other peak, Mullach Buidhe. Like a wane. Right, back over to North Goatfell, down the Biala, back up to Goatfell over there. balloon floating around. It's Goatfell up there. I recommend anyone to do the ridge though. Go up North Goatfell, Mullach, whatever it's called. Do a lot, so I think next time I come here, I'll start from Sanox. Come right up that way, right over the ridge. So you hide it all. Right, nearly a Goatfell and up my sandwich. Summit of Goatfell, Soggy Hall Street. Well, like it is with every mountain, it's a long weary road back down. There's Brodie Kerr there. It's 5 to 3, there's a ferry at 4:30, so an hour and a half to get back there. I think I can make it. If no, I'll have to wait till the 1910, 1920, whenever it is. There should be more frequent ferries to Arran, really should. It's a fantastic hill this. If you can do this, you can do most mountain roads. Say that because it's no easy. But it's a lot of folks' first hill. A lot of scrambling at the top over the rocks as well. And views are second to none. We've got a bus back along. This brings me out at the castle. So we'll see what time the buses are. No doubt they'll coincide with the ferry anyway, so I might be able to get one instead of walking all the way. Because that time my feet will be sore going down over all these rocks. Oh, don't think anybody likes going downhill and walk out. Can't moan, it's a fantastic day. I love North Goatfell, and that Mullach Buidhe, whether it's called, it's beautiful up there. I ran a bit like a Wayne in a toy shop, just with all the different views, it was just gorgeous. Come to Arran if you can. Scotland in miniature. It definitely is. All the beauty, all the grandeur, just a wee bit weird. The end. 8 miles. Now,